Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma akala ahadun ta'aman qattu khayran min an ya'kula min 'amali yadihi." The hadith tells us that no one eats better food than which he eats out of the work of his hand. Islam orders its followers to be hardworking, to be laborious. Islam wants to see all of its followers to be self-dependent. It does not allow the believers to be burdened over other people of the community. But everyone should strive hard to earn his lawful money. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, condemned beggary. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also said that the beggars, the people who are asking other people without any valid reason, such beggars, the professionals, they will come on the judgment day and they will have no flesh on their faces. They insult themselves by begging in this world and they will be insulted on the judgment day in this way. So this begging is very much condemned in Islam if there is no valid reason behind it. And the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Al-Kasibu Habibullah, the one who works for himself is a friend of Allah. Allah also likes the people who work hard and who want to remain self-dependent. And according to the teachings of Islam, it is an obligation on a Muslim man to earn money for his family. The first most important duty on a Muslim is to believe in articles of faith. The second duty is to establish the pillars of Islam. And the third one of the obligation on a Muslim man is to go out and earn money to fulfill the basic needs of the family. It is an obligation. We cannot say that if a person is earning money by doing his business or by doing some kind of job that he's wasting his time, he is running after the world. No, it is one of his duties. And when a person is busy in this obligation, he is given the reward for that. Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also said, the sins of a person who returns home exhausted in the way of Allah, earning the lawful money for the family, are forgiven. Allah forgives the sins of such people who work hard to remain independent financially and they earn the lawful money with effort. So they are basically in ibadah. It is some kind of, you can say that earning money in a lawful way is an act of worship as well. So that's why Muslims should work hard. This hadith teaches Muslims many things today and we have to implement it in the way, especially Muslim men, because you know the financial responsibilities are given to men and not to women. So Muslims, men, all of them should utilize their abilities. They should utilize their skills to earn money. Even the messengers of Allah, they were not given the risk by Allah directly, but all the messengers of Allah also had some source of income. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was the first man on earth. Allah taught him farming and he used to do the farming to get the food. In the same way, Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam, Allah taught him the making of armors, and iron was just like wax in his hand. He used to make armors and sold them. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, when he was a child, he worked as a shepherd, and when he was young, he was worked as a trader with Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. So there was some source of income for all the prophets. But when we are going to earn money, we should also make sure that we are earning only from the lawful ways. The people who are earning the money from unlawful ways and in unethical way, they are also working hard and they are also spending their time, but they are doing something unethical. Like we must avoid bribery, we must avoid cheating and all other forms of unlawful means of income. When we are going out to earn money and we are working hard, we should also make sure that we are earning it in the lawful way. Otherwise, all the effort will be wasted and it will become a sin, obviously, for you. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, once a person came to him and he asked for financial support, and the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, saw that the person was healthy enough to earn money. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked him that you should not beg in this way, but you should do something to earn money. He said, I have only 2 dirhams. What can I do with these 2 dirhams? Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, asked him to buy an axe and cut the wood and sell it. And he said, it is far better than asking other people for financial support. So even Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, did not encourage the people who are begging without any valid reason, but he encouraged the people to work hard to earn money. We should not feel shame in any kind of earnings. As long as something is halal, we should not feel shame in doing that kind of job. It is far better than wasting your time at home, than becoming a burden on the other members of the family and the community. And you should try to improve your source of income. You should try to expand your business. You should try to get a better job. But whatever is available right now, we should do that and we should try to become self-dependent. So we should maintain our self-esteem, we should maintain our self-respect. It is very important to spend an honorable life. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.